YouTubers, hope you're well. TK here, and more bike footage from the Crocolis. This time I'm using the external microphone, the lapel mic. I've clipped it behind my shirt because of the wind noise, so I'm not sure if you can hear this. Very windy today. Going to be heading towards the guided busway. The bike I've got is a 2002 Raleigh Proline, sort of special works bike. It's probably heavy by today's standards. I mean, it uses Reynolds thin wall tubing. It's a steel frame. It's light for a steel frame, but obviously it's heavy compared to the aluminium alloy frames, and obviously infinitely more heavy than carbon fibre. But as a product of the time, it was good. This bike has been everywhere. I've used it in all weathers, although I don't really like cycling in rain and stuff like that, but it's yeah, use it as much as I can. As long as I get the time to go on the bike, I'll use it. Right, this bike, as I was saying, is a Raleigh Proline. And it's about 10 years old. It's been absolutely superb. Made by a Raleigh special products based in Nottingham, and what I liked about the bike is it came with a full instruction pack and a photograph, a signed photograph of the bloke who built the frame and then assembled it. So I think it's a nice touch. Okay, just going to be going over this stye. Not a bad jump. Right. Got an 18 speed setup, again all Shimano DRXT components. The cartridge bearings on the hubs, so they're all sealed. And I'm running parallel with the guided busway on the left. Not sure if you can see that. I won't go through the water yet because the camera's got its external mic plugged in, which means the back, which is waterproof, has to be folded down. So I'll avoid the big puddles. This area's been recently landscaped for local schools and fans of wildlife to do pond dipping. It's a nice little boardwalk here. How about that? Absolutely superb. Got a brace of swans there. Is that the correct word? Brace? There's a couple of herons flying by over there, just out of camera shot. It's very windy now. It's a shame. Got picnic tables over there. But yeah, it's nice around here. that clicking, that's because there's a toggle over centre catch that keeps the rear screen and rear hatch watertight, but you have to open it to connect up the external mic, so it means the toggle catch is free to flop about. What I might do is probably put a little bit of foam, a bit of foam rubber over the top when I'm recording like this. It'll stop any annoying rattles. Although having said that, I'm using the external mic, so you might not even hear it. Now the sound of the Crocolis on the built-in microphone, which is just under the camera mount itself, is a little bit, yeah, it's not too good. But then most of the times these cameras will be used for you'll just be getting video footage. It won't be used for sound, so I can put up with that. And it's quite easy to record your sound on a separate device, such as a Zoom H2 or an H1, or even an iPod, iPhone, and then sync the audio in your editing program. And there's loads of videos on YouTube how to do that. And it's easier than it sounds. Now, all this area here used to be industrial. Well, it used to be gravel extraction, or what they call mineral extraction. Pretty much just the edge of the Cambridgeshire Fens has got a lot of gravel, and so a lot of these lakes are man-made, but they're now all sculpted and they're absolute haven for wildlife. What I like about the Crocolis is because there's no moving parts, you don't have to worry about vibration trashing the mechanism. Right, we're just going to cross the busway. Now all this, now we're just pointing down towards, ultimately towards the Cambridge end, and the other way is to St.Ives. Now the whole track, 11 point something miles, has all been tarmacked. Used to be this compressed sort of MOT type 1, which was no good for road bikes and was hard work even if you had an off-road bike, because obviously it's a bit slippery, and in the winter it used to get wet and you'd be covered in this like white plaster of Paris type material. Now they've absolutely, you know, it's smooth tarmac, it's an absolute pleasure to use, and this is very well used for people that are commuting from St. Ives to the nearest, maybe the park and ride or wherever. So we'll continue back. Welcome back these tyres, sounds like an old Land Rover with the and you've got off-road tyres on the smooth tarmac. Actually, so from my point of view, you might not be able to hear this, but it actually sounds like a tube train accelerating. Now this is a request stop. There was a bus just coming in now. Look left and right here because cars use that to access the RSPB car park, which is on our left.